with Michael Walsh there as well, holding him. Ryan and Liam's British title belt. Two twins who hold British titles at the same time, John.
Ladies and gentlemen, Frank Bullen from Queensbury Promotions, sponsored by Coral and Rainham Steel, proudly presents 12 three-minute rounds for the British Featherweight Championship, live from the York Hall here in London's East End. Your officials are appointed by the British Boxing Board of Control, and your three scoring judges at ringside are Mr. Jeff Hines of Reading, Mr. John Keane of Kettering, and Mr. Marcus McDonnell of Twickenham. Your board representative is Dennis Gilmartin of Islington, London. Your timekeeper at the moment is Mick McCann of Harrow. And when the action begins, your referee in charge is Mr. Michael Alexander of Doncaster. And now to introduce the contestants. Firstly, fighting out of the red corner stands the challenger, a man whose unbeaten record reads 11 wins with 5 KOs to his name. At yesterday's weigh-in, he scaled a stone, 30 pounds and 10 ounces. And tonight, he wears the blue and white shorts. Please welcome from Aberdeen, one loss, one draw, with 8 KOs to his name. At yesterday's weigh-in, he scaled 9 stone, and tonight he wears the black shorts. Please welcome the featherweight champion of Great Britain, from Cromer, Norfolk, England, instructions to both boxers.
Most of both know the rules, so let's just have a go. Most of all, number 10. Okay, just course.
Ladies and gentlemen, 12 threes for the British Featherweight Championship.
Referee Michael Alexander could hardly make himself heard over the noise of the crowd here. Always a great atmosphere here at York Hall, and the travelling Walsh fans are making it electric tonight. Darren Trainor, not too much support here in the arena, but back home in Aberdeen and across Scotland, I'm sure plenty of his fans will be hoping that he can spring what would be a sizeable upset.
Oh, good right hand already there from Ryan Walsh.
Walsh struggled last time out, didn't he, in his defence? Before Christmas, back in September, was it? At Wembley against Samir Muniemni.
Well, that was
again a fighter who fought off the back foot, wasn't it?
Well, there's a slick stare, you know, and I think it was an uncomfortable style, but the two judges had him a wide winner, to be fair, even though I ended the other way.
Yeah, it was Terry O'Connor and Michael Alexander, the referee in there now, who saw him as a big winner. Marcus McDonald is the one who agreed with you. And had Ryan Walsh as a beaten fighter, according to his card. He's come out trying to throw bombs, hasn't he, Walsh, in this opening round?
Yeah.
Really trying to load up.
Oh, good right hand, lovely shot. And again, but a good response there from Trainor as well.
Massive opportunity for Darren Trainor.
Couple of low blows there from Ryan Walsh.
Twin brother is the current British super featherweight champion. Liam.
Good left hook in that exchange and a right hand over the top again. But Walsh switches so seamlessly from southpaw to orthodox, and then back again. Trainor got to get that jab into play.
Train wreck, he calls himself. He admits that he sometimes looks for his right hand too much, and that can leave him open. Walsh dominating this opening round.
Lovely left hand there from Ryan Walsh, beautifully timed. That's the problem training's going to have with Walsh, is that just when he's thinking about setting up an attack, Walsh switches his stance. You've got to reevaluate how you're going to attack him.
Solid right hand, good body shot. Sharp start, this is.
Lovely right hand. Oh, this response back though from Walsh.
Talking to him.
I think he was saying training that caught the elbow or something, but good first round that, John.
And lively, wasn't it?
And a good round there for Ryan Walsh. That was straight off the bat, wasn't it? Pretty much straight after the first bell sound. Right hand to the body there as well.
Sharp start, wasn't it, from Walsh?
But yeah.
Trainer did catch him with a good-looking right just before the bell there. That was good one shot. Which he got through with.
Even though it was a Walsh right, what Trainer proved is that Walsh just can't throw the punches and stay there. You've got to throw, keep moving all the time, because Trainer's got to fire back.
Deep breath, yeah?
That's his twin brother, Liam, with his back to you.
The most important thing, he can't hit you, he's too slow, it'll hit you when you move your feet.
Graham Everett, big lad leaning over the ropes on the left.
And Graham Everett there with the perfect advice, you know, you've got to keep moving your feet.
Now, what can Trainer do to find a way
right hand
maybe to
trainer.
Win the second round? He started nicely.
I think Trainer got to double up the jab. He's got to try and keep Ryan Walsh. Easier said than done. They're keeping it at long range.
Oh, good shot. Good right hand from Trainer. And Walsh very nearly touched down. He felt the power of that right hand there. And suddenly the Scottish contingent getting very excited. Not many here, but they appreciated the power and the timing of that.
And it was a nice long right hand. That's what I say. You've got to keep him at range, keep him at long distance if he can. Try and get him on the end of the punches.
Twice the Scottish ABA champion, Darren Trainer.
Oh, what a response there from Ryan Walsh. That's funny. And all that was because Ryan Walsh moved his head. Moved his head to the right, come back with the right hand.
That's a spicy little fight, this, so far.
Oh, good shot again there from Walsh. A little bit more weight behind that jab, just Trainer.
Darren Trainer trying to become the 10th Scotsman to become the British featherweight champion.
Just landed with a nice little sharp combination there, though, Trainer.
Scott Harrison in recent memory, maybe the highest profile. Paul Appleby, John Simpson, going back again, and back a bit. The likes of Bobby Neal, he was a good fighter. Trainer looking to the referee for a little bit of support in that last exchange, suggesting that Walsh was taking the law into his own hands a little. He's working the body well here, Walsh. Good shot,
yeah,
again,
good,
from
lovely.
Trainer.
Again, from that distance. Oof. One fight off of that uppercut there, Ryan Walsh. He's got to move his head more there, Walsh, when he comes forward.
Trainer's got a reach advantage, and he's having some success with these predominantly right hands thrown from range.
Nice little hook over the top there from Walsh again.
David McAllister's trainer, Darren Trainer's trainer, if you pardon the words, saying he's giving him a boxing lesson. I'm not sure that's quite the case, but he's having some success in his second. Good round.
Yeah, good round.
Trying to do enough?
No, I couldn't split him, John. I think Ross landed some good quality shots as well.
Keep to the sharp boxing. You can't handle it. You really can't handle it. You've got such...
There's that right hand. Whoa, he almost
shot.
Went.
Yeah, well-timed shot. Lift that elbow up as well, just to chop down with the punch.
I'll tell you what, he did well to stay upright there, almost defied the laws of gravity.
Double jab, double jab.
He had more success than that as well.
That's it, nice and sharp. Keep it in the middle. And right hand straight through. Every single time you hand right in the side of the head. You can't take him forever. Okay? Nice and sharp. One, two. Keep the hands right and box
straight. Okay.
Darren Trainer says that he used to hang around with the wrong crowd as a kid. Had drug problems. That's on the streets of Aberdeen. And through boxing, he's turned his life around. Now he says his life is all about earning a living and providing for his two young daughters. And if he can carry on here, he's still very much in this fight. Good second round, Barry scoring it level. Trainer landed the more eye-catching shots of the round, I would have said. That's a good punch from Ryan Walsh. Styles are gelling nicely.
Yeah, they are. It's a good fight to watch so far, isn't it? It's nice and sharp there from Walsh. Got to keep working that jab there, Trainer. That's it, good.
Product of the Granite City Amateur Boxing Club, Darren Trainer. Walsh almost smiles at him, doesn't he, every time he lands something of note. That's good. Great response as well.
Yeah, a bit better from Walsh, wasn't it?
Quality uppercut.
Bit low with the right hand there, Walsh.
And the clash of heads. Trainer didn't like it. Just dabbing a little bit worried. Has he cut him?
Yeah,
has he cut him? I think he has. It's the clash of heads that did it, and Trainer didn't like it. Again, there's that little smile on the face of Walsh. And he talks to him again, Walsh. Corner men are going to have to work on that eye of Trainer.
Oh, nice long hook.
And it's not looking good. Smear of blood there. It was definitely the clash of heads that did it.
Yeah, it really was. So a jab there from Trainer. He's just getting caught with a hook, a right hook, counter hook from Walsh a little bit too often.
Another good round.
Yeah, it is.
Good work from Walsh. A little bit of eye-catching success in the closing seconds of the round. And again, good uppercut. Walsh happy at the way things panned out in the closing seconds. Meanwhile, in the Scottish corner, anxious patching up. And that eye not only cut, also swollen.
Well, I think it was a left hook, it was, John. There was no head clash.
Well, let's have another look.
It was a right hand on the leg. He went low with the right hand, came back with the left hook. Didn't see anything there, actually.
Well, that's a strange one, that, isn't it? There's certainly a low punch.
You look classy. Mix it up. Every now and then, throw the straight right instead of just a jab.
Be dirty like him.
Yourself.
He's been a dirty bastard.
You've
been a dirty bastard. That's it.
Fairly frantic advice. Fourth round on our card, Ryan Walsh ahead, defending his British featherweight title. looked for all the world, didn't it, in sort of real time, as though it was a head clash.
Yeah,
but
it still might have been, John, actually, because the left hook looked like it was on the more to the back of the head than the eye, so a strange one.
Well, they've done the...
Might have slid down, slid across the face. Good jab there from Trainer. Good right hand there, you're doubling up, Cromwell, that's better.
It's a nice confident start, this from Trainer. Corner trying to keep his work rate up.
Another good right hand. He's landed with Will almost, Ryan Walsh, when he throws that lead right hand.
Yeah. That's been the shot which has done the most damage.
Oh, not far off there with that right hand, Trainer. Trainer just needs to bring the jab back a little bit quicker. Good body shot.
The only defeat on Ryan Walsh's record against Lee Selby, the current IBF champion.
Not bad at all, is it, that one?
Make a tasty rematch somewhere, wouldn't it? Good shot. Power shot from Walsh.
And the right hook to follow as well.
And that's put Trainer into reverse gear. And again, big left hook. Oh, great shot.
Lovely hook.
It's that lead right hand that you've been praising.
Trainer, to his credit, might still keep trying to get that jab into play. But the right hand's been a little bit quiet from Trainer in this round, and Walsh has been ticking him off a little bit.
Is he just starting to assume control? Trainer needs a big finish to this round. Head's going in again. The referee says nothing.
Well, there's nothing wrong with that, really. Trainer was holding, Ryan Walsh kept working. Trainer's trying to push Walsh back now.
Walsh talking to him all the time, isn't he? And trying, I think, to keep his own concentration levels high. Good round for the Walsh round.
Yeah. Another round there from Ryan Walsh. The Trainer's still in the fight though, John. Good shot there. That right hook's been a lovely shot for Walsh. The Trainer's still trying to fight back even when he's under pressure. Under fire, still looking to get his own punches off.
Looking quite calm up there, aren't they?
Deep breath, yeah.
In marked contrast to the other corner.
Well, you've got that cut to deal with now, haven't you? So, you know, that makes things a little bit more frantic, doesn't it?
Altogether more animated, the advice in the Scottish corner while you were watching Ryan Walsh there. Into the fifth round. And Barry's got Ryan Walsh 3 points ahead. Oh, good shot. Trainer's best punch so far was back in the second round, wasn't it? That right hand which almost put Walsh down.
Shot there, left hook, right hook from Trainer. Ryan Walsh is, I think if Ryan Walsh is moving his head, Trainer struggles to find the target.
Trainer needs a couple of big rounds, you sense, and he's not going to get them by absorbing shots like that.
No, I think, well, I'm just a little bit lazy with his punches there, Trainer. The effort has been great so far, but I mean, just a little bit too slow with that right hand, and that's why he got caught.
Lovely work again, switching attack from body to head, Ryan Walsh.
Trainer too slow to bring the hands back, and Walsh making him pay for it.
Never seem to be in a dull fight, do they, the Walsh lads?
No. Well, Liam Walsh versus Paul Atwood, he might be the best fight boxers has ever shown, John.
Well, it was our very first night, that, wasn't it?
I was sat here as a punter.
Great fight. Oh, good shot.
Good shot.
Oh, hey, Paul Atwood is in trouble, he goes! Right hand's put him out, and I don't think that is going to be one from which he's going to get up. Clean through the ropes. And it's all over. Ryan Walsh takes him out in style. Brave effort from Darren Trainer, but when it came, Ryan Walsh found quality shots and the big right hand, which served him well right the way through the fight. It accounted for Darren Trainer, and it is celebration time for the Norfolk boys.
And rightly so, that was a good performance, wasn't it? I think against Trainer, remember, Walsh goes in a massive favourite in his fight, almost with everything to lose. Trainer comes in with nothing to lose, comes in and has a good go to Darren Trainer. But Ryan Walsh just slowly started to take control of the fight, and by the last couple of rounds, then dominated everything, made Trainer miss with ease, and a great little finish there from the British champion, who I've already said yesterday, I think is above British level right now.
He was clever, he was so accurate. There's the first right hand, back we go towards the ropes, and another right hand, through you go.
It's a good finishing, good quality work there from Walsh, making Trainer miss, making him pay with that right hand.
Bullying back across the ring with three scoring left hands.
It was a little bit of a bullying display at the end. I think Trainer proved his worth, I think, as a challenger tonight. But Ryan Walsh, as I said, proved why he's the British champion and why you know, he's going to be a hard man to take that title off.
Good fighter and a good crowd, and now a very happy crowd. Trainer still getting a bit of attention in his corner. Brave efforts, had his moments in that second round when he came so close to putting Walsh down.
He had more than moments, more than just a second round, John, with his moments. I think he boxed quite well, you know. He landed with some good shots, and I think Ryan Walsh can be quite elusive. And he caught him because he was a taller guy. I used that long reach at times. But I think Walsh just physically too strong for him in the end, that's what he was. And counting in him, every time Trainer brought that jab back slow, come back with a faster punch, made him pay for his mistakes.
Well, Trainer now manages to get up off his stool. Doctors just checked him out. And Ryan Walsh sportingly asking the crowd to give him their appreciation as well. It takes two to make an attractive fight, and as far as it went, that was a very competitive fight, which ultimately Walsh proved superior and taking it by a pretty spectacular knockout. Two fighters then are together with the referee, and here's Mark Burdis.
Ladies and gentlemen, at 2:06 of the fifth round, Darren Trainer has failed to beat the referee's count, the winner, and still the British featherweight champion from
One of his big ambitions is to take the treasured Lonsdale belt outright. Well, Ryan Walsh moves a step closer. He is still the British featherweight champion. Brave effort from Darren Trainer, the Scotsman, all the way down from Aberdeen. But it's another celebration night for the Walsh family and the Farmy Army.
Thank you, John. John Rawling, Barry Jones, your ringside commentator. Charlie will be chatting to Ryan Walsh very shortly. Pressure makes diamonds, he said before this fight, and that's a glittering performance from the champion. A brave challenge from Darren Trainer from the Granite City of Aberdeen. Had a moment in the second round when he looked like they might turn things round, but very much on the receiving end, and Ryan Walsh's dream of a Lonsdale belt lives on. Tommy, your thoughts?
A very, very good performance by Ryan Walsh. I was really impressed with the way, you know, he was only making trainer miss by like inches and coming back with nice chopping counters. And that right hand was, you know, he was countering with it beautifully all night from both the southpaw and the orthodox position. So, you know, he broke him down slowly and then finished it off. It was a good, solid performance.
This fella, we'll have to ask him back. He got his prediction Eleven, about eight. Right, didn't he?
He's always right, this fella. I was sick of eight being with him.
He got it right. But trainer, perhaps a little level too far. Good on him. Best possible shape. He's got power in that right hand, doesn't he?
He come to this fight with 11 or 12 fights. He only beaten one man with a winning record. And he got well beat in the end, but he was competitive in there. And if that knockout hasn't, you know, doesn't leave a mental scar, he can become a better fighter for that.
Okay, looking behind us at ringside, Charlie has with her the man who is still the British featherweight champion.
I'd say I've also got the whole hashtag Walsh pack going on as well with me too. Ryan, a huge congratulations. I was presenting your fight, your last fight out at Wembley, and we saw a huge improvement. I know that you wanted a massive improvement when you actually won the title. Defending it out there, do you think there was a big improvement for you?
Certainly in the result, that's what Trish Dixon once described as a full stop finish. No controversy, I'm really happy. Before I start, you can hear him still now. I have to thank each and every one of these people who come out tonight. We didn't have enough tickets tonight. These people have travelled all around the country, and I have to say thank you to them. Just a thank you to the two people, Leon and Simon, because without that type of group and that following, it wouldn't be worth it. This is something else. I'm so happy. I'm trying to soak it up, so I owe everything to this. You see this? This isn't a team, this is family. From Graham to Manuel, my brothers, that goes without saying. I'm so happy, I'm really happy, yeah.
Yeah, I want you to enjoy it, but I do want to ask you a few more questions. We can hear the Farmy Army that are kind of just behind. They've got like a massive flag as well with the Farmy Army. They're still here cheering you on. Can you talk us a bit through the fight, though? I want you to go back to round two, if you can remember it, where he...
He punched me here.
Yeah, he punched you with the right hand, and you almost, very almost, went down.
Did you? I don't know if you can see. If you look back on the camera, I looked at him, I went, I didn't see that one. They're the worst shots, the ones that you don't see. He's quite heavy-handed. His record suggests that, and... If you don't see it, you're gonna feel it, and I think that's a little bit cold, a little bit not concentrating. It was really,
Seen him look like being rocked. So fair play to the kid.
It took the box.
Learning curve, brilliant.
I ticked the box. I'm happy with that, and that's improvement in itself, isn't it? I hardly got hit in the last fight, as awkward as it were. I never got hit like that, did I? So that's another ticked boxing for tonight.
Yeah, and trainer definitely got in the ring and gave it a good go because it's slightly lower level than you. Going to the fifth round then, talk us through the knockout.
I can't remember a thing. I just know once I got him, I really tried to keep on him. It was really awkward and it made it hard for me to do what I wanted to do. And I give him full respect after 11 fights taken on myself. I've been around this circuit a long time now. I'm 8 years into this game and I give full respect to trainer for turning up.
Misquoted.
Oh yeah, I've been misquoted recently. Thank you for that.
Go on then, correct us.
Yeah,
what you mean misquoted?
The quote that was something around I'd underestimated my opponent, so he's not on my level. That's not true. I've never ever done that. I train and get in the shape I get in every time because I believe that like the opponent could beat me, and I treated Darren with that respect, and that's why he got my best performance. And I give him ultimate respect for taking the fight on 4 weeks' notice. He's a man after my own heart.
We know you've had a fantastic training camp, but it looks like over in Tenerife. What did you think of your brother's performance?
I thought it was good. 5 out of 10.
Yeah, do you want to get in as well?
I do. It's a 10 out of 10. It's been a fortune on the knockout, a fortune. Oh, we've had a good day today.
So go on. You said 5 out of 10, so what could he be improved on? Come on, go on.
I know what he's capable of. I know.
What more to come?
He's capable of. And yeah, it was a good performance, but still plenty more.
That's because I got punched in the ear, I'm telling you. If I would have got punched in the ear, I might have got a 7.
Any of you guys, do you want a word as well, Graham?
No, I think he's done really well. He's going to improve every fight. You'll see him out again within 90 days. And he's just going to get better and better. He's moving on to world class.
So you mentioned world class there. I know before this fight, you were asked quite a few questions about what was next, whether it's the big boys now, whether it's holding the Lonsdale belt outright, whether it's a rematch with Lee Selby down the line. You've got a lot of options. I know you really want to enjoy it. I don't want you to kind of think too far ahead, but where do you want to go?
I want to go as far as I can physically possibly go. And these two people beside me, with Liam's experience and Michael's love output and experience,
I'm sure, and with Graham and Manuel, I'll be guided in the right direction. Everyone knows I'll fight anybody at nine stone. That's anybody. I fought a world-class opponent. Everyone knows. I won't keep talking about it. He probably gets fed up with me talking about him, so I won't. But everyone knows I fought a world-class opponent. I didn't shut myself up. I'm improving. Yeah, I need some more time. That performance shows it, but and maybe more rounds. But what I will say is, at nine stone, I'm so confident. I'm the leanest, cleanest nine stoner on this planet.
And we just saw that, and we did see a big improvement. Thank you very much, and I'll let you soak it all in now. And it's nice to see you all, and the big smiles on your face. Go on, one more.
The last one. I know I made a few fans happy tonight. I never get a knockout, so well done for you for sticking with me. Thank you to all the fan behind me, all that travelling. I can't say thank you enough.